I know that, sir, but think of the disastrous effect this might have on the morale of the American teenager. No, I am not suggesting that the boy doesn't want to go into the army. It's just that... No, I'm not trying to... Well, it seems to me that... 2 weeks from today, at the induction center, he'll be there. Rosie, thank God you've come. This is the end of Almelu Music Corporation. Conrad Birdie's going into the army.
And your faithful secretary is hereby submitting her resignation.
Huh?
I just dropped in to say goodbye, Albert, darling. Lots of luck.
Rosie, you can't. Not today, today of all days. My pills. Where are my pills? The little white ones I take when I'm overwrought.
Here.
Not so much. Break it in half.
You're 33 years old, Albert. You can take a whole aspirin.
I'm not 33. I'm a long way from 33. I won't be 33 until tomorrow. Water!
It's no use, Albert. I've made up my mind. I've been with Almelu 8 years now, and as you well know, I have been much more than just a secretary to you.
Rosie, those were moments of madness.
Well, between the moments of madness and the office, I've put in a good 90-hour week.
I get it. You want a raise.
Wrong. You know what I want.
Rosie, if you're referring to anything of a more permanent nature between you and me, I'm not ready for it. And besides, there are religious differences.
Spanish is not a religion!
If it's part of the company you're after, well, the answer is no to that, too. Almelu is me, Mama, and Lou, and any changes in it would kill that wonderful woman who bore me.
Nothing could kill your mother, Albert, except maybe a silver bullet.
And I won't drop poor old Lou, either. He loved you, Rose.
I loved Lou, too. Sure, he was warm, he was loyal, he was lovable, but he died 6 years ago, and besides, he was a wire-haired terrier. Anyhow, I don't want a part of the company. This is something much more important.
Rosie, if you're going to discuss what I think you're going to discuss, I'm in no mood to discuss it.
There is nothing to discuss, Albert. Conrad Birdie's going in the army. I've quit. There's nothing you can do but give up the business and go back to college and get your...
Rosie, I'm up to my ears in debt. Conrad's got a $50,000 guarantee, which I can't pay. And I've just taken a severe overdose of aspirin.
Albert, this may be your last chance. Will you listen to me, Albert? I'm serious. His going in the army is the best thing he could do. Now you're free to start to do what you wanted to. Albert, Albert, Albert. I remember how you told me I should trust you for a year. It would just be for a year, but it's 8 years, Albert. 8 long years, Albert.
Rosie, it takes time to build a business.
It was only a sideline, that's what you said. You just needed some money, that's what you said. You were going to college and get ahead. Instead of being a music business bum, you were going to NYU and become an English teacher.
Rosie.
And furthermore, he wrote poetry.
Oh, Rose, please.
And in the NYU yearbook for 1952, under Albert Peterson's favorite piece of literature, do you know what it says? Little Women.
I'm ruined in show business.
An English teacher, an English teacher, if only been an English teacher, we'd have a little apartment in Queens. You'd get a summer vacation, and we would know what life means. A man who's got his master's is really someone. How proud I'd be if you had become one. It could have been such a wonderful life. I could have been Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Albert Peterson, Mrs. Phi Beta Kappa Peterson, the English teacher's wife. And it was goodbye, Geoffrey Chaucer. Hello, William Morris. goodbye NYU, hello Al Malu, 'cause when you wrote Conrad's first hit, Ugga Bugga Boo, then I knew that was it. You were through with English forever. An English teacher is really someone. How proud I'd be if you had become one. It could have been such a wonderful life. I could have been Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Albert Peterson, Mrs. Phi Beta Kappa Peterson, the English teacher's wife.
Rose, I'll make a deal with you. Stay with me. Help me get the money to pay Conrad's guarantee, and as soon as I'm out of the red, I'll dissolve the company and go back to the academic life.
Albert, you're on.
Of course, it may take a few years, but I'm sure that by 1973 or 74 at the latest, we'll... What's this?
Something that'll push that date up a few years. Pick a name.
Pick what name? What are you talking about?
All right, I'll do it for you. McAfee. Kim McAfee, age 15, president and recording secretary of Conrad Birdie Fan Club, number 2748 of Sweet Apple, Ohio.
Mary, would you get me Sweet Apple, Ohio? The number's capital 78820, and call me right back.
Now, wait a minute. What's going on here? Who's this Kim, whatever her name is?
Kim McAfee, Albert, is what's going to send you back to college with the biggest hit song this business has ever seen. It's called One Last Kiss.
I never heard of it.
You haven't written it yet. But when you do, and when that one last kiss is from Conrad Birdie on his way into the big cold army for 2 long years, and when he gives that one last kiss to one of his fans chosen at random, from 1,200,000 hysterical teenagers, it'll make Mr. Birdie the hottest soldier since Joan of Arc.
I'm beginning to see it, Rose. We cut the record here in New York.
Take Conrad, that greasy bongo-playing car thief, to Sweet Apple.
Let him kiss the kid.
And release the record. Albert, you'll have enough money to stay in college for the rest of your life.
Rose, it's wonderful. And I promise you, as soon as this thing is settled, it'll be just the two of us, Rose, living in perfect bliss. I'll get a job teaching English and... Bliss. Kiss. That rhymes. Oh, I wonder if anyone's ever used it before. Oh, it doesn't matter. It'll be great for the song. Oh, one last kiss. It gives so much bliss. What is your dentifrice? No, that's too clinical.
An English teacher, an English teacher. Someday he may be an English teacher. Yes? Well, every phone in Sweet Apple can't be busy. What's going on there? Kim McAfee just got pinned by who? Never mind, Mary. Just keep trying and call me right back. Then we would have such a wonderful life. Then I might be Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Albert Peterson, Mrs. Phi Beta Kappa Peterson, the English teacher's wife.
Hi, Nancy. Hi, Helen.
What's the story? Morning glory.
What's the tale? Nightingale. Tell me quick about you going camping.
Hi, Marty.
Get pinned?
Did she kiss him and cry? Did he pin the pin on? Or was he too shy? Well, I heard they got pinned. I was hoping they would. Now they're living at last.
Mr. Engel, this is Harvey Johnson. Can I speak to Penelope?
Is it
wasn't true about Kim.
Penelope?
I just knew it somehow.
About the prom.
I must call her right up.
Saturday?
I can't talk to you now.
Hello, Mrs. Miller. This is Harvey Johnson. Can I speak to Deborah Sue? Well, Mrs. Darfine, is Charity home from school yet?
Records, but things like the pledge and the Conrad Birdie scream are past me now.
You're giving up the scream? You mean when Conrad Birdie sings on television, you're not gonna go, ah! Oh, Kim!
Kim, dear, would you please get off the phone? I have some calls to make.
All right, Mother. Sorry, Ursula, I've gotta hang up. You'll explain everything to the other kids, won't you?
I suppose I'll have to. Bye, Kim. Kim, are you sure? Are you absolutely sure?
Positive. After all, I'm 15 years old and it's time I settle down. When you're a skinny child of 14, wired with braces from ear to ear, you doubt that you could ever be appealing. Then, hallelujah, you are 15 and the braces disappear, and your skin is smooth and clear, and you have that happy grown-up female feeling. How lovely to be a woman, the wait was well worthwhile. To wear mascara and smile a woman's smile. How lovely to have a figure that's round instead of flat. Whenever you hear boys whistle, you're what they're whistling at. It's wonderful to feel the way a woman feels. It gives you such a glow just to know wearing lipstick and heels. How lovely to be a woman and have one job to do, to pick out a boy and train him, and then when you are through, you've made him the man you want him to be. Life's lovely when you're a woman a fancy nightclub and stay out after 10. How lovely to be so grown up and free. Life's lovely when you're a woman like me.
Kim, there's a call for you. The operator said she's been trying to get through for nearly 3/4 of an hour.
Thank you, Doris. I'll take it down there.
She said it was long distance, and I can't imagine who could possibly be... What did you say?
I said thank you, Doris. Oh, there's no need to look so upset. It's modern to call your mother by her first name. It makes the mother and daughter more like pals.
And your father?
Oh, I'll call him Harry, naturally. By the way, I think Harry took the news about Hugo and I awfully well, don't you, Doris? This is she.
Yes, I'll wait. I don't know. Yesterday I was mother, today I'm a pal. Are you sure you wouldn't like to call me Mom? That's modern.
I'm sorry, but times are changing. And you've got to go along with them or be left behind with the old folks. Oh, by the way, Doris, have you got a cigarette? I seem to have run out.
I'm not an old man. I was 18 in World War II.
Conrad Birdie is coming here to kiss me? Doris? Mother?
Now you just put your head on Mommy's
shoulder.
You don't
understand! Conrad Birdie is coming here to kiss me goodbye! Oh, Mommy, Mommy, Mommy!
I never thought I'd say it, but God bless Conrad Birdie!
Girls, sorry I'm late. Now let's go over the Birdie song once more before going down to the train. Why don't you stand over here? All right, now, shall we try it?
We love you, Conrad! Oh, yes, we do!
Oh, wait, wait. Girls, you can sing with us if you want. What's the matter with them? I think they've still got a few good years left. Look, why don't you girls go down to the train and I'll try talking to them. And stay out of the bar! Hi, I'm Albert Peterson, Conrad's manager. Oh, come on now, that's no way to be. Things can't be that black. Smile! Girls, this is an adult speaking. I order you to smile. Please? Gray skies are gonna clear up, put on a happy face. Brush off the clouds and cheer up, put on a happy face. Take off the gloomy mask of tragedy, it's not your style. You'll look so good that you'll be glad you decided to smile. Pick out a pleasant outlook, stick out that noble chin. Wipe off that full of doubt look, slap on a happy grin, and spread sunshine all over the place. Just put on a happy face. Put on a happy face. Put on a happy face. And if you're feeling cross and bickerish, don't sit and whine. Think of banana splits and licorice and you'll feel mind. I knew a girl so gloomy, she'd never laugh or sing. She wouldn't listen to me, now she's a mean old thing. So spread sunshine all over the place, just put on a happy face.
Gosh, there's our luggage. Hurry up, girls. You better get down to track 12 if you want to see Conrad before he goes. Oh, boy, can you get that stuff down to track 12 on the double? Rosie, what are you doing?
Getting our things. Down to the station. Without any help. From you, Albert.
Oh, Rosie, I'm sorry. I don't suppose a generous tip would make anything up.
Albert, you just take your briefcase and go down to that station before any of those reporters talk to Conrad alone. You know what happened last time.
You hang on to it, Rose. I've got to wait for Mama.
Speaking of your mother, Albert, have you told her about dissolving Alme Lou?
I couldn't, Rosie. Yesterday was the anniversary.
Of what?
Lou. 6 years ago, he was hit on 181st Street and Broadway by a loaded beer truck.
Yeah!
Do you suppose that's Mama?
It's either her or the all clear.
Yoo-hoo, Sonny!
Mama! Mama, what's the matter?
Don't worry about me, Sonny. I'm just a little faint. From the subway.
Mama, I told you to take a taxi.
Oh, taxi. What do I need with taxis? I'll save the taxis for my successful son. A mother can ride crowded in a dirty subway full of foreign people. Wouldn't give you a seat if your life depended on it. But what's the difference? Nowadays, a mother is lower than dirt anyway.
Here's the money I saved from not taking the taxi. Buy some candy with it.
Who's she?
Mama, you know Rose Alvarez from the office.
This is Rose Alvarez? Pretty little Rose Alvarez? I can't believe it. Rose, what happened? You had a sudden shock or something?
Albert, I think I'll go see if Conrad's here.
By all means, Miss Alvarez. Look at her, Sonny. How nice she looks. It's a wonder some older man doesn't come and snatch her off. A personable matron like that with brains and a few dollars. What a catch you'd make for a convalescent. Goodbye, Rose.
Goodbye, May.
Call me Mrs. Peterson.
Now, Mama, what I wanted to discuss with you is sort of about Rose. Maybe you'd better sit down.
Why? I know my Sonny. He loves his mama. He isn't going to say anything that would break her heart. Go ahead, Thea, what about Rose?
Well, it's about Lou, too.
Lou! Where are you, Lou? Struck down by a beverage which I consumed faithfully for 32 years! What about Lou?
Well, Mama, Rose thinks, and I agree, that I should give up Almay Lou. Mama, what's the matter?
Oh, nothing's the matter. You killed me, that's all! Lou, I'm coming! I'm on my way up!
You don't understand, Mama. It's just that Rose thought, look, Mama, here's some money. Take a cab home. The subways are too crowded.
Nothing is too crowded for a mother. I'll go during rush hour. That's the worst time. Wait a moment. How many blocks is it after all? Oh, only 107. I'll walk.
Mama.
Enjoy yourself, son. Take care. Wear your heavy coat. Be careful crossing the street. Keep your money in your inside pocket. Wear your rubbers and eat a hot lunch.
Albert, I thought we were breaking it to her gently.
Well, as a matter of fact, Rosie, I didn't tell her at all. I mean, she was so upset about my leaving, I thought I'd better wait.
You mean you didn't even tell her that...
Conrad Bernie's coming!
Come on, Rosie, Conrad's coming in. We can't let him talk to those reporters.
But alone. Albert, you promised
later,
me that...
Later, Rosie, Conrad needs me later.
But Albert's a real. You ask how he feels. He's much too shy to tell you, so I'll tell you how he feels. He feels brave and eager, strangely humble, proud to be a plain GI.
He will gladly face those bullets, for he's not afraid to die.
Sing!
We love you, Conrad! Oh, yes, we do! We love you, Conrad! And we'll be true! When you're not near us, we're blue! Oh, Conrad, we love you!
Very nice!
Is he engaged? Is Conrad engaged? There's absolutely nothing to the rumor he's engaged.
Pal, like a sister, but it doesn't mean a thing. And that 18-carat diamond, it was just a precious ring.
For he's a kind of sinning patriotic, now we are a
perfect boy. Then why was her husband so mad?
Safe.
We love you.
Oh, I'll always remember when Conrad first got accepted into the armed forces. Say, Mr. Peterson, he cried eagerly, do you think I'll get assigned to one of those frontline trenches? That way I can get me one of those dirty jerrys.
Albert.
Or whoever's dirty this time.
Give us a real scoop. Conrad's still drinking a lot.
Now listen here. This gossip must stop. He goes to church each Sunday and he doesn't touch a drop.
He's as decent as a minister.
Absolutely.
Over as a judge, he subscribes to every charity, and his hobby's making fudge.
He's a kind of patriotic, healthy, normal, boy.
That is
a lie through and through. I'll tell you where he came from. Here's the story, and it's true. Son of missionaries there,
on a 1,000-acre farm,
very poor and very hungry,
from a line of wealthy planters,
what a cruel life to bear,
full of gentle southern charm.
Soon he drifted down to a rock
farm, by the river,
to a waterfront saloon.
In the moonlight they would croon.
That is where I heard him
That's
sing.
That's when Conrad started singing.
Underneath the hung of moon,
plantation moon.
We
Yeah.
going with Conrad.
But Albert, I want
to make Conrad's speech for him. Get the bags, stack them, and bring them to the house. If I see a taxi, I'll send it back. For these.
Kim, before you go, can I talk to you for a minute?
Right now? I mean, couldn't it wait a minute? I'll go hurry.
I don't think so, Kim. It's important.
Hugo, Peabody, would you possibly be so important that you have to talk to Kim right now?
What's so important? I'll tell you what's so important. That after I give her my pin, she goes around kissing someone else. That's what's so important. I'll have you know I'm quite upset about this. I've already had several headaches. Me and the nosebleed.
Oh,
me jealous. Why, I'm the opposite of jealous. I'm very jealous, and I have every right to be. Kim's my steady.
That's just it, Hugo. I'm your steady. Oh, I may admire Conrad Birdie as one admires a far distant and unattainable ideal. But I'm pinned to you, Hugo, and I don't care how common and ordinary you are. That's how I'm gonna stay.
You want to say that to make me feel better?
I mean every word of it, Hugo. Conrad Birdie is just a flame. The steadiest forever.
One boy, one special boy. One boy to go with, to talk with and walk with. One boy, that's the way it should be.
That is fresh air. The youth are going by.
great pride and prejudice, as well as the usual pomp and circumstance, that we welcome you to our city and present you with this 14-carat solid gold key, so generously donated by the men at the Sweet Apple Brassworks. And as I present this key to you, Mr. Conrad Bird. What happened? All I said was Conrad Bird. Now, girls, if you don't stop that, I can't finish my speech.
Who cares about your speech? We want to hear from Conrad. Speak to us, oh, beautiful one, and tell us how you make that glorious sound that even now, in anticipation of it, has reduced me to a snarling, raging, panting jungle beast.
Gotta be sincere. Edna, what's the matter?
Gotta be sincere.
Mr. Birdie, what are you doing?
You gotta be out here, 'cause if you feel it here, well then you're gonna be honestly sincere.
What you do to really feel it, make them feel it too. Write this down now, you
gotta be sincere, honestly sincere. Man, you've gotta be
sincere.
You're really sincere, you're really sincere. If you feel it in here, then it's gotta be right. Oh, baby. Oh, honey. Hug me. Suffer. My sincerity shows through. I'll look you in the eye. I don't even have to try. It's automatic. I'm sincere. When I sing about a tree, I really feel that tree. When I sing about a girl, I really feel that girl. I mean, I really feel. If you're really sincere, if you're really sincere, if you feel it here, then it's gotta be right. Oh, baby. Oh, honey. Help me. Suffer.
To sing the birdie song 10,000 times, didn't we?
got 5,276 to go. So stay up!
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes, we do.
Please, Daddy, I wish you'd hurry. I want to have this mess cleared away before Conrad comes down.
This mess, as you call it, Kim, happens to be my breakfast, and I intend to enjoy it.
Now, Kim, your father has a right to enjoy his eggs, but I'm sure he won't mind if we just quietly start clearing away some of these other things. Now, I know the house is a bit hectic this morning, dear, but Kim's gone to a lot of trouble to fix a special breakfast for Mr. Birdie, and I want to make sure everything's ready for him when he comes down. After all, he is a national figure, and I want to show these New York people we know how to treat a national figure here in Sweet Apple. Of course, it doesn't matter much to me personally, but for Kim's sake, I... Here we are, all done. Did you enjoy it, dear? Good. Now, if you'll just hurry along...
Doris! I am not budging from this room till I get my coffee, smoke a cigarette, and read my paper!
Oh, I'm sorry, dear. I forgot to make your coffee this morning. How about a nice warm 7-Up?
Morning, Pa. Here's the paper. Hope you don't mind, but I cut out a few stories about Conrad.
I have tried to run this house on a democratic basis. I've extended the privilege of self-determination to both the woman I have married and the children I have sired. The vote has been denied no one for reason of age, sex, or political affiliation. There has been no taxation without representation, and open covenants have been openly arrived at. Last night, I gave up my room to a guest who repeatedly referred to me as fats. Telephone calls were made to New York, Chicago, Fairbanks, Alaska, and Hong Kong. I slept in a camp cot with my feet in a fireplace and my head in an ashtray. Outside my window, three harpies shrieked, "We love you, Conrad!" 4,723 times. I have just lost two fried eggs. Gentlemen, the democracy is over. The parliament has been dissolved. The Magna Carta has been revoked. And Nero is back in town. And you do not offer an emperor a warm 7-Up.
Oh, Mr. McAfee, I hope you don't mind keeping off the phone for a few minutes, but we're expecting a long-distance call from New York.
Oh, perfectly all right. I'll just go out and burn Rome.
Mother, what's wrong?
Oh, nothing, dear. Your father's just excited about Conrad being here, that's all.
He's coming, he's coming!
He's coming. I'll get the eggs, Mother. You call the kids.
Girls, you better hurry if you want to watch him eat.
Here we are, Kim.
Oh, sorry, Doris, but we just had to come too. We'll stand quietly back here.
Here he is.
Call me for lunch. Hi, fats.
Oh, now look here, Doris, about that boy.
Please, Harry, he's just shy.
After all, Doris, Kim is only 15.
Please,
and I
Daddy,
don't want
Daddy, not
her.
In front of everybody.
I don't care who's here. No ill-mannered lout
Harry.
Is going to...
Tell him, Pa!
You shut up! Doris, this is my house, and until you're 18...
But, Daddy...
You shut up until you're 18!
But, Daddy...
Will you leave me alone?
Mr. and Mrs. McAfee, Kim, Randolph... Is this really how you want 75 million Americans to see you?
What are you talking about?
You're all going to be on television with Conrad.
We're going to be on
television?
That's right. I just got the confirmation from New York, from Ed Sullivan himself.
You mean, we're going to be on the Sullivan Show? The Ed Sullivan Show?
That's right. They're gonna cut in on Sweet Apple at 8:05 this Sunday evening, and you're all gonna be on. So that's why I beg of you, Mr. McAfee, to put aside all petty differences. To that great audience out there, you're an American dream come true. And for the free world's sake, Mr. McAfee, don't destroy that dream.
Me on the Ed Sullivan Show. Ed Sullivan! Me, Harry McAfee, appearing with Ed Sullivan! Ed Sullivan! Ed Sullivan!
Ed Sullivan! Ed Sullivan!
Ed
Ed
Sullivan! Ed Sullivan! Ed Sullivan! We're gonna be on Ed Sullivan.
How could any family be half as fortunate as we?
We'll be coast to coast with our favorite host, Ed Sullivan. I've got a wonderful wife, two swell kids, a good job, and now this!
Someday we'll recall the greatest day of all.
Ed, I love you!
Ed, so.
What do you think?
It looks great, Rose. Now, there's something I wanted to talk to you about.
Of course, it's been used as a movie house for the past 30 years, but I think it'll be fine for the TV show.
I'm sure it'll be swell, Rose. Now, what I wanted to say...
Now, they're shipping down all the cameras and the lights today, and whatever we need for costumes, we can...
Rose, I'm sure everything will be perfect. Now, if you'll just forget about the Sullivan Show for 1 minute, there's something I want to talk to you about. About you and I, Rose.
You and me, English teacher.
Rose, I'm serious. What I wanted to say was that... Ever since we left New York, Rose, it's made me see all kinds of things in a different light. And that's why I wanted to let you know that I wrote Mama to tell her that no matter what happened, I've decided to give up Almaloo.
Oh, Albert, you didn't.
But I did. I wrote her the day we left, so that gives her 3 days and 3 nights for her to get in touch with me. And so far, not a word. If you've asked me, she's accepted the whole thing by now.
3 days and 3 nights on a trailways bus. But what's the difference? I'm only a mother, and for a mother, a trailways bus is good enough.
Mama, what are you doing here?
Did you think I wouldn't come? A woman gets a letter, obviously written under the influence of drugs, and she should stay at home. Pay no attention. It's only a mother's tears. Dear Ma, this is to let you know that Almaloo is dissolved. Your friend... Albert! Almaloo is dissolved! Dissolved me! Who am I, anyway? Oh, just some sick old woman probably won't last the night. I just want a simple stone with one word carved on it. Albert's mother! And don't bother hiring a limousine to take me to the final resting place. I'll walk!
Mama?
And tell that Spanish friend of yours I forgive her. She knoweth not what she doneth.
Mama, Rose is right here.
This is Rose? I can't believe it. She looks like Margot when they took her out of Shangri-La. For her own sake, Sonny, send her back to Tibet. And don't worry about the secretary. It so happens on the bus I met the perfect secretary, a wonderful, refined girl. On her way to Akron, only I convinced her to get off here. Sonny, say hello to Gloria Rasputin.
Hey, pal. Hey, you're cute.
But, Mama, I don't need a secretary. I have Rosie.
Ah, what does Rosie need a job for? In a year or two, she'll be getting Social Security.
Well, listen, I don't just type.
You do other things?
I tap dance. I figured I could help you with the secretary stuff, and you could help me get into showbiz. Here, hold this, honey. Maybe you can help me with the Swanee River.
It's my favorite selection.
Get a load of this, pal. Hit it, May.
Da-da-da-da-da.
I don't know. I mean, you certainly have wonderful qualifications, but I'm used to working with Miss Alvarez. However, as you say, Mama, we are faced with a certain amount of extra work, and... Do you have to stay down there?
For a minute or two. Thanks. You help me out. You'll go to the other side.
Sonny, for the movies, they can always cut away while they jack her up. Why don't you take Gloria somewhere and see how fast she types?
Well, I do have all these releases to get out, and Gloria can do them. As long as that doesn't make any difference to you, Rosie.
Why should it make any difference to me?
Atta girl, Rosie. You just stay here and I'll go along with Miss Rasputin.
I'll find you a typewriter.
Do you use the touch system?
I could kill him. I could just kill him. Oh, I could wring his neck. I can't believe all she had to do was do a split and then she could pay attention to me.
But I'm looking for Kim McAfee. I want her to know that she is not to kiss Conrad Birdie on that Ed Sullivan show tonight. Because if she does, I'll... Miss Alvarez? Miss Alvarez? Is anything wrong? It's me, Hugo Peabody. Can I do anything for you, Miss Alvarez?
Why, yes, Hugo. I think you can.
Where's Ed?
Oh, one last kiss. Oh, baby, one last kiss. It never felt like this. No, never felt like this. You know I need your love. Oh, 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 give me one last kiss. Oh, one more time, oh baby, one more time. It really is sublime, oh honey, so sublime. You know I need your love. Oh, 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 give me one last kiss. Baby, give me one last kiss. Baby, give me one last kiss. Oh, one last kiss, oh baby, one last kiss. It never felt like this, no, never felt like this. You know I need your love. Oh, 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 give me one last kiss.
One last kiss, one last kiss. Oh, give me one last kiss.
Oh, one last kiss.
One last kiss, one last kiss.
Oh, give me one last. Okay, brace yourself, chick.
Brace yourself, Conrad Birdie!
Hugo, you hit him!
He deserved it! He was a thief! A thief of love!
Hugo Peabody, I never want to speak to you again!
Kim! I demand to know who's responsible for this! Who let that kid in here?
I did, Albert.
Rosie!
Take it as a farewell present for you and Miss Rasputin. Wear it in good health.
Rosie, wait! You can't leave me here alone!
You're not alone, Albert. You're on television.
For he's a fine, upstanding, patriotic, healthy, normal American boy. For he's a fine, upstanding, patriotic.
patriotic, healthy, normal American.
That's all I'm through. Albert, dear, to put it sweetly, to hell with you. That's right, Albert, to hell with you. From now on, it's going to be me, Rosie, on the town, singing, dancing, having a ball, making up for 8 years of being in love with a mama-clutching, aspirin-splitting, six-foot tower of jello. What did I ever see in him? How did I ever get involved that way? Now that it's over, I can smile and say, what did I ever see in him? Boy, I was way out on a limb. Now that my feet are on the ground again, now that my senses have been found again, what did I ever see in him? Is he tender? No, he's not. Is he thoughtful? No, he's not. Am I crazy? What's he got that I found so damned appealing? What did he ever do for me? Well, to be honest, he was sometimes nice, but still it wasn't worth that awful price. It was rough from the start. Broken dates, broken nails, broken heart. How did I ever, why did I ever, what did I ever?
Don't be upset, Miss Alvarez. All men can't be like that. Every one of them, except maybe Albert Schweitzer, but I'm not his type. They're all the same, from puberty to senility, from Benedict Arnold to Mussolini. I never understood why Ingrid Bergman married him in the first place. Egotistical, selfish human beasts. Then what are we poor women to do, Miss Alvarez? Use them. Take them as our playthings, while we live. Sip from the cup of life. Mix the potion full strong and drain it to the dregs. How do you like them apples, Mr. Peterson?
Do we need them? No, we don't. Do we want them? No, we don't. Will we leave them? No, we won't.
Tell me, what did I say that for?
What did we ever see in them? Well, to be honest, they were sometimes nice, but still it wasn't worth that awful price. It was rough from the start. Broken dates, broken nails, broken hearts. What did we ever see in
Hugo F. Peabody? Huh? Hugo, what did I ever see in him? Why, he's as bad as Mr. Peterson, if not worse. Miss Alvarez, I'm coming with you. Don't be silly, Kim. You're only 15. Juliet was 14 when she left home. And look what happened to her. Now look, Kim, why don't you go downstairs and get some milk and cookies like a... It's too late for cookies, Miss Alvarez. I want to live. We can sip the dregs together. We'll help each other with our potions.
For the last time, Albert, I'm okay, and I don't feel like getting into bed. Now leave me alone.
Conrad, be reasonable. You've just had a severe shock, so the best thing for you to do is... Aha! There she is, the traitor who stabbed me in the heart while my back was turned.
Albert, let me by.
Be careful, Sonny. She may be armed.
I think I can handle her, Mama. You go with Conrad and see that he gets into bed.
Wait for me, Conrad. I'll make you a nice hot cup of terramycin.
Albert, for the last time, will you let me by? I'm going out on the town tonight, and I don't want to waste another minute.
Not until I've had my say, Rose. I just wanted to let you know that thanks to Mama's quick thinking, the kiss will take place after all, tomorrow morning at the train station, just before Conrad leaves. So it looks like you failed, Rose, as anyone must fail who tries to buck Al Peterson, one of the giants, the titans, one of the King Kongs of the music industry.
What did I ever see in him?
How did I ever get involved that way? That it's over, I can smile and say, what did I ever see in him? Broken heart!
An empire builder, a colossus.
Out of my way, you defrocked English teacher.
Ow, Rosie.
What did I ever see in him?
Rosie, Rosie, come back. Do you hear me? This is King Kong calling. Rosie, Rosie, I need you. Come back, please, Rosie. And I don't care how you plead and beg, Miss Alvarez, you're through here at Almelu. Not only do I accept your resignation, but furthermore, you're fired. And just remember one thing. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never harm me. You big rat! Sorry to have to do that in front of you folks, but I've just had to let Miss Alvarez go. I'll get that.
Probably Hong Kong again.
Hello, this is Albert Peterson speaking. I'm sorry, Mr. Lewis, but Miss Rose Alvarez is no longer with us. That's right.
Miss Alvarez, wait for me, I'm coming.
And where do you think you're going, young lady?
With Rosie, to drain deep the dregs and sip full hearty the brimming cup, to live.
Upstairs.
But Daddy.
Upstairs, do you hear me? I said upstairs.
Miss Alvarez was right. You're all the same, from puberty to Mussolini.
What's that? You dare say puberty in front of your own father? Not to mention Mussolini. Doris, we failed as parents. I didn't ask for much from my children. Just a little respect. That's all I asked for, a little respect. But did I get respect? I did not get respect. I get no respect.
I respect you, Pa.
I don't want your respect. You're a child. What good is respect from a child? Doris, take me to my room. I'm not a well man. Certain words I didn't want to hear in this house. Puberty was the first. Mussolini was the second. And respect was the third.
Now look here, Mr. Lewis. No 3-cent reporter can happen to bulldoze me. I happen to be Albert J. Peterson, and you can print that in whatever cheap paper you happen to represent. It's not a paper, it's a magazine. And it's not Mr. Lewis, it's Mr. Luce. Rosie, I need you.
Sonny boy, where are you going?
Nowheres, Mama. Just out. It's stuffy in here, so I thought... to look for Rosie, Mama. I love her and want her back.
Oh, is that all? I thought it was something serious. By all means, Sonny, go and find the Lady of Spain and bring her back here. Oh, and by the way, dear, when you get back, be sure to stop by the kitchen. Take my head out of the oven and turn off the gas!
Mama...
it's a strange house. I don't want to run up the bill.
Mama, I've had enough of this. If you really loved me, you'd help me find Rosie before it's too late. Don't you understand what's happened? The poor girl's got out to make up for all the years she wasted on me. Who knows what low dive she's in at this very moment?
Ah, Sonny, you're right. I'll help you find her. Only, maybe I better give you the message from Conrad first.
What message?
Oh, nothing to worry about, Pierre. It's just that he's going out tonight, and he doesn't think he'll be back in time to kiss Kim tomorrow.
Mama, why didn't you tell me this before?
I tried to, darling sweetheart, but you kept bringing up a certain party from south of the border.
I don't know what the matter with him is. He knows how much this means to me. Conrad! Conrad!
Take it easy, I'm coming. And before you start hollering, Albert, I want you to know that I've made up my mind. I'm tired of getting up at 9 every morning, having people watch me when I eat and letting kids poke me in the eye. I want to go out, have some fun, you know, meet a couple of young chicks. Don't you understand, Albert? I'm tense.
Mama, don't just stand there. Do something.
Conrad, did you ever think in terms of a more mature woman?
Man, I hope I never get that tense. Now listen, buddy boy, this is my last free night before I'm going to the army, and I'm going out.
You can't go out without my permission. It says so on your contract. Mama, get the contract. Never mind, I'll get it. You stay right here.
Oh, Conrad.
There are chicks just right for some kissing, and I'm me to kiss me a few. Man, those chicks don't know what they're missing. I got a lot of living to do. Sizzling steaks all ready for tasting, and there's Cadillacs all shiny and new. Gotta move, 'cause time is a-wasting. There's such a lot of living to do.
There are men of 19 or 20 who are suave and reckless and true. Older men who give a girl plenty. I've got a lot of living to do.
There's music to play, places to go, people to see. Everything for you and me. Hey, you kids live here, don't you?
Yes, Mr. Birdie.
So what's the lowdown on this town?
Well, Sweet Apple, Ohio was founded in 1852 by Jeremiah and Apple.
I mean, what do you do here? Where do you go to have a ball?
Well, there's a sweet shop in the church basement, and some of the older kids go to the high tower.
What's there?
I don't know, I say yes.
It just so happens, Mr. Birdie, that the ice house is where people go when they want to be alone.
Hey, ain't you the chick I was supposed to kiss?
I am not a chick. I am a fully grown woman, and I insist on being treated as such. As a matter of fact, that's why I'm running away from home.
Now you're talking, chick. Come on, let's move. We got things to do.
Crazy clothes and motorboat races. Someone nice to cuddle up to. Broadway lights and wide open spaces. There's such a lot of living to do. Lots of dates and no one to go to. Look at the blue and laugh at the view. Moonlight swim and someone to hold you. We've got a lot of living to do.
There's music to play, places to go, people to see. Everything for you and me.
Oh, my God.
If only you know it. And it's all just waiting for you. You're alive. Such a lot of living. What a lot of living too.
Alice, where are you? We know you've almost reached
that. Alice! There's music to lot of living. What a lot of living to do.
Kim, come back. Kim,
Where are you? Hugo, have you seen Kim?
Oh, don't ask me. Ask Conrad Birdie.
What are you talking about?
They're out together having motorboat races. Moonlight swims. Loop the loop. I'm gonna do the only sensible thing. Drink myself to death.
Moonlight swims? Motorboat races? Loop the loop? Doris, get my gun.
Ah, Mr. McAfee. You haven't seen Conrad, have you?
No, but I intend to see him, Mr. Peterson. So if you have a message, I'll be glad to deliver it to him. Right after I shoot him.
Shoot him. Rosie, I've got to find Rosie.
Dear, what are you talking about? You know you don't have a gun.
There's a Daisy air rifle in the garage.
That's mine, Pa.
You, shut up. I wonder where I can buy BBs this late at night.
Anyway, it's broken, dear.
Then get me anything. My daughter has run off to loop the loop with a fiend. Get me a water gun. Kids, I don't know what's wrong with these kids today. Kids who can understand anything they say. Kids, they are disobedient, disrespectful oafs. Noisy, crazy, sloppy, lazy loafers. And while we're on the subject, kids, you can talk and talk till your face is blue. Kids, but they still do just what they want to do. Why can't they be like we were, perfect in every way? What's the matter with kids today? Kids! I don't mind the moonlight swims. It's the loop that hurts. Kids! Why don't they lower the draft age to about 11? Kids! I didn't even know what puberty was until I was almost past it. Kids, they are just impossible to control. Kids, with their awful clothes and their rock and roll. Why can't they dance like we did in a romantic way?
Hey, Pop, here's my pea shooter.
Pea shooter? What good is up? Give it to me. What's the matter with kids today?
I'll have a double rocks on the scotch and put some rocks in it this time. Can you make a vodka malted?
How old are you?
32.
Get out.
What about a beer?
Beat it.
Can I just sit here with an empty glass in front of me?
Out.
I demand to see the manager. Where's Maud?
I'm Maud. Charles F. Maud. And if you're not out of here in 1 minute, I'll grab you by the scruff of your neck and throw you.
Okay, I'm going. This is the last time I do my drinking in this place.
Double bourbon, scotch on the side, no ice, with a cherry in it. And make that 2 cherries, and bring on the dancing boys. Alvarez is the name, but you can call me Spanish Rose.
Spanish Rose?
See?
Yes. Out.
Now, wait a minute. I'm an American citizen, and it's my constitutional right to have a drink here if I so choose, and get loaded here if I so choose, and do any manner of wild and trashy things here if I so choose. This is Spanish Rose's coming out party, and when I say coming out, I mean coming out.
So that means there's a man involved?
No, a mama's boy, and she hates me.
Well, mama's boys mamas always do. So what's the problem?
I'm just a Spanish tamale according to May. Right off the boat from the tropics far, far away. Which is kind of funny, since where I come from is Allentown, PA. Spanish. Okay, May, I'll be Spanish. Just wait till I've married Alberto. I'll be the toast of Chichi Castanango. And all day long my castanets will click. I'll hide behind my fan and do the tango. I'll be so Spanish, it will make you sick. I'll eat the tacos and the enchilada. I'll drink tequila till I feel no pain.
The only song I'll sing will be Granada. I'll be more Espanol than Abby Lane. Craziest flower that grows. I'll kick up my heels and see how it feels to be sultry Spanish rose. Olé!
Mi name Rosita Hernandez. Sister of Spanish beauty, que será? You like me, yes? No, maybe? Yeah.
Let me give you a bit of advice. To cross Spanish roads isn't wise. Your match you have found, so don't mess around. Her heart, she is cold like ice. With Albert, I will dance to the bolero. We'll cha-cha in the nicest honky-tonks. He'll wear the cutest mustache and sombrero. My handsome Latin lover from the Bronx. So, now that you've met Spanish Rose, you'll never forget Spanish Rose. She'll taunt you, she'll tame you, but what man could blame you for worshipping Spanish Rose? Not Danish, not British, not Swedish, not Yiddish, but Spanish!
Hello, this is Albert Peterson speaking. Is Rose Alvarez there?
Oh?
Rose Alvarez. In fact, I think that's her voice I just heard. Could you put her on, please?
Oh, Duarte. Hey, hello, Casper. There's someone on the phone named Peterson who wants to talk to you.
You tell that weaselly little rat that I'm not here.
That proves she's there. Who else would know I'm a weaselly little rat? Rose, I've got to talk to you. It's about Conrad.
And furthermore, even if I were this Rose, which I am not, the one thing that would make me hang up is any mention of anybody named Conrad.
No, Rose, don't hang up. I won't mention Conrad. We can talk about anything you want. You, me, I, anything. Oh, Rose, please.
Talk to me, baby, won't you talk to me? I don't care what you say, baby, talk to me. Must you be so far away from me? It seems all wrong this way, talk to me. And if you miss me, tell me so, are you lonely? Tell me so, say you love me. Tell me so, honey. Let me know. Talk to me till I press close to me. Then you'll see, we won't have to talk at all. I don't care what you say. Talk to me.
No, I'm liking you lose. It ain't gonna hurt.
And if you miss me,
tell me so.
Are you lonely? I press close.
Are you alone?
No, I'm not alone, Albert. I'm with friends. See you later, boys.
See you later? Boys? Rosie, you've got to help me find Conrad.
And that's just the beginning, Albert. From now on, the sky's the limit. Parties, balls, dances, and... What's going on in there?
Whoa. No business of yours, lady. That's a private dining.
Private for whom?
For men only, that's what I mean.
Men only? That's exactly what I'm looking for. I know what goes on in these small towns. Out of Spanish Rose's way!
Wait, Spanish Rose, don't let her go in. Mama, get my coat!
Hey, lady, wait!
And so, fellow Shriners, with the power vested in me... Before the recording secretary reads the minutes from last week's meeting, I want to bring up a subject that I'm sure is on everybody's mind tonight. There was a... As I was saying, gentlemen, there was a...
Thank you.
back in there and get me some grain alcohol to go?
Not for $1 million.
But my whole world is collapsing before me. I can't get a drink, and Kim's run off with Conrad to the ice house.
Kim, Conrad, the ice house. Albert, I've got to phone Albert. Hugo, you stay right there.
There she is.
Now, fellas, wait a minute.
Come back! You spicy tamale!
Here it is, Mom's roadside retreat. I'm coming, Rose. Hurry, Mama.
I don't know why we have to go running around all night looking for someone we'd be better off not finding in the first place. If you'll listen to me, Sonny, you'll come home, have a nice cup of postum, and go to bed.
Mama, I told you I'm not coming home until I find Rosie. Now, if you want to go home, that's okay with me. In fact, that's not such a bad idea. Well, why don't you go home, Mama?
What did you say, sweetheart, darling?
I said, why don't you go home, Mama?
Would you mind repeating that once more? Sunshine of my existence!
I said go home, Mama. I don't need you any longer.
So, it's come at last. At last it's come. The day I knew would come at last has come at last. My sunny boy doesn't need me any longer. Well, what are you waiting for? Get rid of me. Put me out with the garbage. Just throw me out with the used grapefruits and the empty cans of tuna fish. And never mind putting a lid on. Leave it open so 100,000 pussycats can walk all over a mother. Who bronzed your baby shoes and kissed? Oh, every little brute who picked your dirty socks up off the floor. You cough, and who was there? It's just too hard to bear. A mother doesn't matter anymore. With bunions on my feet, I trudge through snow and sleet to bring you licorice from the corner store. I sold my Tiffany lamp so you could go to camp. Now a mother doesn't matter anymore. That's it. I'm ready to go, and I don't want you to spend a cent. Fancy funerals are for rich people. Just wrap me in a flag and dump me in the river on Mother's Day. And precious, by the way, the doctor called today. What, I got a condition? Yes, he sure. There's nothing they can do. Alas, a week or two. Because for a condition, there's no cure. The time you had the croup, who made you chicken soup and read you Bambi till her throat was sore. No, a mother doesn't matter anymore. Ah, there. I feel better now. Everything is as it should be. A mother is lying on top of a sanitation truck, bound for the city dump. And a son is running around with some floozy who came looking for a good time and stayed to ruin an American woman's life. Gave up nights of rest to rub fists on your chest. Who nursed her sunny boy till he was four. My life has been in vain. This country's down the drain. Cause a mother doesn't matter. No, a mother.
Mama?
Yes, sonny boy.
Good night, Mama.
You're just like your father. You'd marry anything. Good night, sonny boy.
My name's not Sonny Boy.
Good night, Albert!
Conrad and Kim.
Ah, Mr. McAfee, a great pleasure to see you again. Unfortunately, I must tell you that Conrad's affairs no longer interest me. Now I'm off to find Rosie to tell her that Conrad and Kim,
they've run off together.
And if we don't find them soon, Mr. Peterson, I intend to call the FBI.
No, I'm sure there's nothing to worry about.
Where's Harry? Have you seen Ursula?
Ursula?
Is she missing too?
Since 10 o'clock, we look everywhere.
Mr. Peterson!
I'm sure everything's fine. They're probably all down at the drugstore. Maybe having one of those gang wars.
Gang wars?
Kids, I don't know what's wrong with these kids today. Kids who can understand anything they say.
Kids, they're so ridiculous and so immature. I don't see why anybody wants them.
Just you wait and see. Another teenage delinquent.
Why can't they be like you? Are perfect in every way.
What's the matter with kids? Two kids. What the devil's wrong with these kids today? Kids who can best and they return out that way. Why can't they be like we were? Perfect in every way. What's the matter with kids?
Hi, everybody. Good old Hugo here. Float.
Hugo Peabody, what have you been drinking?
Milk. But it worked. Anyway, I've got every right to be drunk. Kim's run off with Conrad to the movies.
Great double bill tonight. Flying down to Rio in Creed. Gosh, I'll always remember that great cast. Dolores Del Rio.
And Jean Raymond.
What a score.
I'd forgotten that.
Albert!
Rosie, where have you been? I've been looking for you all night. And I did it, Rosie. I sent Mama home. And I'm a new man, a world leader.
Albert, Conrad and Kim have gone to the ice house.
The ice house?
The ice house. Doris, call the mounted police. Call Mr. Keene, tracer of lost persons. Call the shadow. Look him up under Lamont Cranston.
Fun, isn't it? Of course, when you've been here as many times as I have. I've been here with just about everybody, you know. Ursula, Deborah Sue, the Girl Scouts. Conrad, you seem a bit nervous. You're trembling. Just because you're a few years younger than I am. I'm 27 or 28, you know. One of those two. So, you see, I really know the score. I even know some of the words. Canubian, premarital, jailbait. There you are, oh, sensuous one. We've been looking for you everywhere.
That's nice. Now out of my way, I'm late.
But you don't understand. We're coming with you. You said it yourself. We got a lot of living to do.
Now, wait a minute.
We'll never go home again. We'll follow you to the end of the earth.
Now that stuff really ain't as much fun as I made out.
We can start right now.
Comrade! He is the depraved brute! Arrest that man! Well now, Mr. Birdie, what do you have to say for yourself?
Thank God you've come!
Hi, everybody! Good old Hugo here again!
Hugo, darling, you're just in time! I can't tell you what humiliation I've been made to suffer.
That's all I needed to hear. Take him away!
Mr. McAfee! Mr. McAfee, I demand you release that boy! Do you hear me?
Albert, let me handle this. Look, I'll go down to the courthouse and you go back to the house and I'll deal with the mayor.
But Rosie, you don't understand. This is the new Albert. I told Mama goodbye.
Oh, Albert, you didn't.
You did.
And Rose, this new Albert's going down to the courthouse to deal with the mayor. And Rose, I'd appreciate it if you'd met me at the railroad station tomorrow morning at 6:30 when I intend to be there with Conrad. And did I mention that I loved you?
Not yet, Albert.
Well, I do. Conrad!
It's gonna be such a wonderful life. I'm gonna be Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Albert Peterson, Mrs. Phi Beta Kappa Peterson. Oh, Rosie, nothing can stop you now.
Hello, Rose.
Hello, May.
Oh, we're alone at last. Have you a moment to spare for a heart-to-heart with an old friend?
I'll always have time to spare for the woman who, by tomorrow evening, I'll be able to call...
Don't say it, Rose.
I'll be able to call Mother.
The cruelest word I ever heard. To think I've lived to see the day I'd have relatives in... El Salvador.
Not to mention Guatemala, Brazil, Chile, Uruguay, and Chichi Castanengo. And as soon as Albert and I are married, I'm going to stick a rose in my teeth, sit in front of my adobe hut on Central Park West, and sell tortillas. Adios, Mama.
Adios, Rosita.
Call me Mrs. Peterson.
There's no one here. Come on.
Now look, Albert.
Shut up and get on that train. It took every cent I had to bail you out. I don't want you seen until we're out of this state. Now get aboard.
Now look, buddy boy. You saved my life, and whether that means you pay me no guarantee or not, you've got a contract with me forever.
Conrad, what are you saying?
Here's a blank piece of paper with my name signed to it. You fill in whatever you want.
Hello, Albert. Oh, Rose, you look good for a change. I know all about you two. Don't worry. I won't make a fuss. I'll just do what any intelligent mother has to do. Goodbye, dear. Don't worry about the coat. You'll have 3 mink stoles as soon as the train passes over me.
Mama, get up and get on that train. I have no time for any nonsense.
Just a minute, Mr. Peterson. I demand to know what you've done with Conrad Birdie. He's not in that jail.
How should I know where Conrad is? I haven't seen him all night. I'm just here to say goodbye to Rosie.
Mr. Peterson!
Now, dear, there's no point in getting excited. After all, there is no real harm done. Kim and Hugo are back together again. As a matter of fact, the sweetest thing happened this morning. He proposed to her and she accepted him. Dear, what's wrong?
My life is over now. I'll sell the house and... go into a home.
All aboard!
Get on! Bye,
Albert. 6:30 on the button. Now, where's the train?
It left at 6:25.
But, Albert, you told me to be
with
here at...
Conrad.
At 6:25. I know, because...
And Mama.
Albert, you wanted us to miss that train.
Well, it stands to reason, Rose. Why get on a train to New York when we have tickets to Pumpkin Falls, Iowa?
What's in Pumpkin Falls, Iowa?
An opening in the teaching staff at Pumpkin Falls High School. I read about it in this morning's paper. They want somebody to teach English and domestic science. Oh, and I hope you brought your documents, Rose, because they prefer the applicant to be married.
Oh, Albert!
Rosie. Did anybody ever tell you that's the most beautiful name in the world? I was never crazy for flowers. I confess that nothing left me colder. I could watch a daisy for hours, and all I'd feel was several hours older. Lilacs or lilies, any bloom you please, all that they did once make me shrug or sneeze. But now I love each blossom that I see, for a lovely little rose loves me. Now my life is rosy, since I found my Rosie. With a girl like Rosie, how could I be through? Hand in hand we'll mosey, me and little Rosie. We will be so cozy by a fire built for two. Oh, I once heard a poem that goes, a rose is a rose is a rose. Well, I don't agree, take it from me. There's one rose sweeter than any that grows, and that's my Rosie. I'm so glad you chose me. Life is one sweet, beautiful song to me. Now my life is rosy.
Oh, we'll be happy, I know.
Since I found my Rosie.
Off to the preacher we'll go.
With a girl like Rosie.
So how could we be,
blue?
Oh, we'll have us a home out west. A nice little split level nest. And in every room, roses in bloom.
But there's one rose sweeter than all of the rest, and that's my Rosie.
I'm so glad you chose me. Life is one sweet, beautiful song. When love is right, then what could be wrong? Life is one sweet, beautiful song to